Hello, everybody. Have a Mackies and surprise from me, Bernard Manning. Come on, let me take you down to my club. We have saved you a table with the compliments of Mackies.
250 Irishmen crammed into a bus, and one said there's an empty one behind, so they all got out of that and got in that. Working man's club. One said, Charlie, one of the committee, he says, Charlie, we put you on the trip to Spain. He said, now you've no right, don't start making yourself busy putting me on trips to Spain, he said. I'm not going, I'm unlucky, me, he said. I'm very unlucky, them planes are always crashing. I'll go, he said, but I'll go by boat. And he went by boat and the boat sank. A plane hit it. I went to the doctors. The doctor said, put your right leg on my desk. I put your left leg on my desk. He said, how long have you been having these dizzy spells? Fell on the floor, you think? No. Two fellas talking, one said, I've been married twice, I wouldn't get married again. He says, why? He said, had a lot of trouble. He said, how do you mean? He said, first wife died eating poison mushrooms. What about your second wife? He said, a fractured skull. He said, how was that? He said, she wouldn't eat the mushrooms. Two cats talking at Wimbledon. One said, our kid's in that racket. Fellow walked in a pub. He said, now look here, he said, I know you're a new landlord here. He said, you keep a nice bottle of Mackies in here, he said, and you keep the beer right. He said, but we've always had snuff on the counter in the vault here. He said, I'll give you a tip. Get some snuff on that counter, else you lose all your vaults there. Be back in 20 minutes. The lad's like a drop of snuff. This landlord thought, where am I going to get snuff for this time of night? So he gets this horse manure, sticks it in the box, dries it into a fine powder. This fella come back, he said, now you're talking. Now you're talking, he said. The lads will then appreciate that, he said. He said, can you smell horse manure in here? The landlord said, there's no horse manure in here. He said, it's a clean pub, this. My wife helps out with the cleaning. He said, I can smell it, he said. Fella walks in, he says, can you smell horse manure in here, pal? He went, no, he said, I can smell it. He said, the place is reeking. This other fellow went up. He said, I'll tell you what, that snuff clears your head. I can smell that horse manure now. Irishman rang Heathrow Airport. He said, could you tell me how long it takes an aeroplane to get from Heathrow to Dublin? He said, just a minute. He says, thanks very much. Irishman went to a scrapyard. He said, have you got a door, sir, for a 1,500 weight Bedford? He said, certainly. He says, how much are they, sir? He says, £5. He says, they're only 50 bob down the road. He says, well, why don't you go down the road? He says, because they've got none down the road, sir. He said, well, when we've got none, ours are only 50 bob. He said, I didn't know that, sir. I'll come back when you've got none. British officer stuttered very badly explaining to this private soldier guard duty. He says, when anybody approaches your post, you challenge them and you say, halt. Who goes there? And if they say, friend, you say, pass, friend. But if they say, you could slip up with this one, my life. Foe, you shoot them. But take your time, because it might be me. This American was talking to this Lancashire lad. He says, listen, buddy, you see that building over there? We've got buildings in America 100 times bigger than that. He said, I'm not surprised that's a bleeding lunatic asylum. Fella walked into optician. He said, my eyesight's failing. I can't see as well as I did. He says, come outside, look in the sky. What can you see? He said, I can see the sun. He said, how much bloody further do you want to see? Two Irishmen talking, one said, lend us £5. He said, I've only got four. He said, you can owe me one. Irishman went for a job on the buses. He says, can you start me, sir? He says, yes, but we've got one-man buses now. He says, I've never heard of them, sir. He says, well, you've heard of them now. There's your bus. On your way. 25 minutes later, phoned up. He'd crashed the bus through Woolworths window. The inspector came out. He said, how the f***ing hell's this loud? He said, I don't know, sir. I was upstairs collecting the fares of the car.
Well, folks, that's your lot. Good night. Peter, save me a Mackison.